show you something I've done. It's outside. I had some big logs and I thought I'd decorate one of them.
It's an ancient Cretan labyrinth. The pattern is up on the website. They've been used for thousands of years as a tool to think, reflect, and pray. They represent the journey of life, our pilgrimage, physical, emotional, and spiritual. They're not mazes, no dead ends, just a journey to the centre. But sometimes that journey goes in the opposite direction. Just keep going. Eventually, you will arrive. You can see why people meditate on labyrinths. Chartres Cathedral has one built into its floor. Our pilgrimage through life and into God, our lives right now. Walk a labyrinth.
From life's beginning to all eternity, there is a song to be sung. In deepest oceans, across the galaxies, in every nation and tongue, let praise resound. Let praise resound. Alive at his command, join the eternal refrain. Sing joyful mountains, you rivers, clap your hands. All nature breathe out his name. Let praise resound. Let praise resound. Be heard, come lift your praises up high. As songs of worship ring out across the earth, as heaven sings in reply, let praise resound. Let praise resound all around. Creation sing.
Praise resound all around creation.
In a few moments of quiet, let's think of the times when we've made excuses to get out of things that God wanted us to do, or when we've said or done things that were wrong. Let's come to the Lord, who is full of love and forgiveness, and tell him about those things. For turning away from you and ignoring your will for our lives, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For behaving just as we wish without thinking of you, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For failing you, not only by what we do, but also by our thoughts and words, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For acting as if we were ashamed to belong to your dear Son, Jesus, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
Together we say,
Father, we have failed you often and humbly ask your forgiveness. Help us so to live that others may see your glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now may the God of love bring you back to himself. Forgive us all for all the things that we have done wrong, and assure us of his everlasting love. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
As we come to you to receive the food of your holy word, take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory. Teach us, Lord, full obedience, holy reverence, true humility. Test our thoughts and our attitudes in the radiance of your purity. Cause our faith to rise, cause our eyes to see your majestic love and authority. Words of power that can never fail, let their truth prevail over unbelief. Speak, O Lord, and renew our minds. Help us grasp the heights of your plans for us. Truths unchanged from the dawn of time that will echo down through eternity. And by grace we'll stand on your promises, and by faith we'll walk
as you walk with us. Speak, O Lord, till your church is built and the earth is filled with your glory. And by grace we'll stand on your promises, and by faith we'll walk as you walk with us. Speak, O Lord, till your church is built and the earth is filled with your glory.
Now that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking with each other about everything that had happened. As they talked and discussed these things with each other, Jesus himself came up and walked along with them, but they were kept from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing together as you walk along?" They stood still, their faces downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, asked him, "Are you the only one visiting Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days?" "What things?" he asked. "About Jesus of Nazareth," they replied. "He was a prophet, powerful in word and deed before God and all the people. The chief priests and our rulers handed him over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one who was going to redeem Israel. And what is more, it is the third day since all this took place. In addition, some of our women amazed us. They went to the tomb early this morning but didn't find his body. They came and told us that they had seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. Then some of our companions went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see Jesus." He said to them, "How foolish you are, and how slow to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Did not the Messiah have to suffer these things and then enter his glory? And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was said in all the scriptures concerning himself." As they approached the village to which they were going, Jesus continued on as if he were going further. But they urged him strongly, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and began to give it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he disappeared from their sight. They asked each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he talked with us on the road and opened the scriptures to us?" They got up and returned at once to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 and those with them assembled together and saying, "It is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then the two told what had happened on the way and how Jesus was recognized by them when he broke the bread.
My training vicar, Clive, used to go out on his bike around the parish. See, his theory was that he'd be able to wave and say hi to folk, but not stand and chat pointlessly. I'm getting a lot of us wouldn't mind some aimless chatting at the moment, and perhaps some not so aimless chatting as well. You see, it's not just chatting, is it? It's the encounter. And it's not just the encounters, it's the events, situations, circumstances, things that happen, well, on the road. It doesn't take much to shoehorn God into this. For millennia, people have journeyed finding God, sometimes to get somewhere special, but I suspect that mostly the God thing happens as they travel, rather than just when they reach their destination. We call it pilgrimage, and it's not just about those who want to reach their 10,000 steps a day goal. The journey is life, and it happens in your flat or house, behind closed doors, or just in the garden, as much as it does out on the open road. That's the romantic view of it anyway. Don't think the reality is as easy and full of spiritual sunshine. What hit me when I read our Bible reading was that if these two friends of Jesus didn't recognize him walking side by side and facing each other over food, then how on earth am I going to achieve anything other than worn out shoes and blisters on this finding God journey? This was Jesus as a stranger, unrecognized. But then there's that bit where it says their eyes were kept from recognize him. What does that mean? No, really, I'm asking. It could be a number of things, but for us today, I don't think it matters. I'm thinking that for whatever reason, it wasn't their fault. It's not as if they decided to cancel the journey or ignore the stranger. For good or bad, they accepted what was happening to them on the way. They listened, they discussed, they welcomed, they ate. Then something happened, and they knew who he was. Jesus went, and then they realized. Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road? Within moments, they twigged. That's how it was for them. But for you, for me, perhaps in a moment, hindsight cuts in. Or maybe it took longer, maybe it takes longer. I guess the important question is whether we're on the road, thoughtfully traveling. Thoughtful travel. Mindfulness with muddy boots. Oh, one last thing. It seems really important what that thing was that led them to recognize Jesus. And you know, it wasn't a brilliant sermon. He tried that and it hadn't worked. It wasn't a bang, flash, wallop miracle. He didn't even bother trying that. And it certainly wasn't a soft shoe shuffle, boy band song and dance routine with smoke machines. It was breaking bread. Just breaking bread. It was just a meal. He did something and they remembered and then they realized. Memories and meaning was turned into a moment of meeting Jesus. But it was through something ordinary, something basic, something mundane. Today, well, it might be bread and wine. For us, it often is. But you know, it might not be. Jesus reveals himself on our journey in different ways. That's why, for us, it's about thoughtful travel. Mindfulness with muddy boots. Surprised by the ordinary, making the connection, and perhaps we will say, were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road?
God in my living, there in my breathing, God in my waking, God in my sleeping, God in my resting, there in my working, God in my thinking, God in my speaking, be my everything. Be my everything, be my everything, be my everything. God in my hoping, there in my dreaming, God in my watching, God in my waiting, God in my laughing, there in my weeping, God in my hurting, God in my healing, be my everything, be my everything, be my everything, be my everything, be my everything. Christ in me, Christ in me, Christ in me, the hope of glory. You are everything. Christ in me, Christ in me, Christ in me, the hope of glory. Be my everything. God in my hoping, there in my dreaming, God in my watching, God in my waiting, God in my laughing, there in my weeping, God in my hurting, God in my healing. Be my everything, be my everything, be my everything, be my everything. Christ in me, Christ in me, Christ in me, the hope of glory. You are everything. Christ in me, Christ in me, Christ in me, the hope of glory. Be my everything, 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 be my everything. Everything, be my 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 everything.
So may the peace of the Lord Christ go with us wherever he may send us. May he guide us through the wilderness, protect us through the storm. May he bring us home rejoicing at the wonders he has shown us. May he bring us home rejoicing once again into our doors. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with each one of us and remain with us now and forever. Amen.